Welcome to our computer class. Dear students, in the previous lecture, we have covered the word processor and the components of MS Word. And in this video, students, we will learn the topic of ribbon in MS Word. So let's start our lecture. Students, here I will show you the MS Word window. So this is the complete window. And here you can see the components of MS Word window, like quick access toolbar at the top left corner. And the topmost bar of the window is the title bar. And at the right side, there is a scroll bar that is used to move up and down in the document. And at the bottom of the window, there is a status bar that is used to display the number of pages, number of words, and so on. And this area just below the title bar, this area is called a ribbon. And in this chapter, we will learn about the ribbon. So students, what is a ribbon? A ribbon is a command bar that organizes a series of tabs at the top of a window, like home, insert, design, layout, references, mailing, and so on. So students, there are three parts in the ribbon: tabs, groups, and command buttons, as you can see in the diagram. The ribbon is the work bar located at the top of the document. Hiding and unhiding the ribbon is optional by clicking on the upper right-hand corner of the page. So students, we can hide or unhide the ribbon. Here, I am going to show you how to hide the ribbon or unhide the ribbon. So students, when you click this arrow, then you can see that ribbon will disappears from the screen. So I'm going to click this arrow. Now you can see that ribbon is disappears from the screen. And now students, if you want to appear the ribbon again, then just click this arrow on the title bar. So I'm going to click on it. When I click this arrow, then you can see that ribbon appears back. So I hope you understand how to hide or unhide the ribbon. Next topic is menu ribbon. From the file tab, you can open this menu ribbon. And here you can open, save, create a new document. So students, here I am going to show you how to open or use the menu ribbon. When you click on the file tab, then a menu ribbon appears. And students, you can create a new file by clicking on new option. And you can also open a document by clicking on open option. And you can also save the document by using the save options. And you can also print a document by using the print option. And you can also close the document by using the close option. So I hope now you understand the menu ribbon. Next is home tab. Students, home tab consists of following features: clipboard menu, font menu, paragraph menu, and styles. So we will discuss them in detail. First one is clipboard menu. It provides the following features: cut, copy, paste, format painter options. So students, here I am going to show you how to use them. So first of all, I am going to write a one sentence for you, like computer is an electronic machine. So now students, I want to copy and paste this line. So what is the procedure? First of all, select this line, and then from the clipboard menu, this is the clipboard menu. So choose the option of copy, and then move the insertion point to the new location, like here, and then choose the paste option from the clipboard menu, Here you can see that we can copy and paste. So now students, how to cut and paste? The same procedure. First select the line that you want to cut and then choose a cut option from the clipboard menu. As you can see that it removes from the original place, and then move the insertion point to the new location where you want to paste your text, like here. So you can click the paste option from clipboard menu, and you can see that now it appears in a new location. So students, I hope you understand the concept of cut, copy and paste. Here I am going to tell you that you can also use the shortcut keys for copy, cut and paste. And now students, next option is Format Painter. So how to apply Format Painter? First of all, select the text whose format, such as font or style, you want to copy. So here I will select this computer word and then click on Format Painter option from the clipboard menu. And after clicking it, drag the painter across the text you want to copy the format to. Like I click on computer, then now students, you can see that font and style of computer word is copied into another word. So I hope so students, you understand the clipboard menu. Next is font menu. To change the font by using different commands, for example, highlight text, italic, underline, change font type and size, etc. So students, here I am going to present you how to apply these commands. Suppose you want to change the font style, then first select the word, then students, choose the font style from this menu. Like I choose Arial Black, so you can see that font style is going to be changed. And now you can change the size by using the size menu. So students, you can see that I apply and now font size has been changed. And now students, if you want to bold this text, then just click B option from the font menu. And then you can also italic that word by clicking on I option. And then you can also underline that word by using the U option. So students, here you can see the difference. Now students, you can also color this text by choosing the A option like this. And now you can also highlight your text by using this option. So students, I hope you understand the font menu. Next is paragraph menu. So it provides help for doing alignment, line spacing, bullets and assigning numbers. So students, now I'm going to present you how to apply these options. For alignment students, here is the paragraph menu and you can choose these four options for alignment. Like I want to align this word example. So there are four options. Left align, by default example is at left align. If I want center align, then I click this option and you can see that example moves to the center. And you can also apply right align and you can also apply justify. So these are the alignment options. Now students, you can also give the spacing between the lines by choosing the line spacing options. And you can see that spacing between the lines increases. And now you can also apply the bullets to these words. How to apply bullets? Select the text and then click on the bullets from the paragraph menu. So you can see that bullets can be applied, and you can also give them numbers by clicking on the numbering option. So I hope you understand it. Next is styles. Students, you can also give the style to the text by simply selecting these styles from the style menu. So students, I hope you understand the home tab menu. So students, in this lecture video we have discussed the menu tab and the home tab. Thank you.